May you Christmas and all I have to say is appreciate your parents, guardians, or whoever's taking care of you, because they're the ones buying you the gifts and putting them under the tree. So remember to stay humble, stay appreciative, and remember, stay loco.
Hey, it's me, Jack Skyblue. And just like with the other years before, I've decided to talk about some of the most positive news that are coming from this year. So, without further ado, let's dive right into it.
India has saved thousands of lives by increasing sanitation coverage from 40% to 90% in just 4 years. The world is literally a greener place than it was 20 years ago, and the data from NASA satellites has revealed a counterintuitive source for much of this new foliage, China and India. This surprising new study shows that the two emerging countries with the world's biggest populations are leading the improvement in greening on land. The effect stems mainly from ambitious tree planting programs in China and intensive agriculture in both countries. In 2017 alone, India broke its own world record for the most trees planted after volunteers gathered to plant 66 million saplings in just 12 hours. A Chinese man has been hailed as the world's kindest crook after security footage has shown him taking pity on the woman that he was trying to rob. The woman, who was identified by her surname Li, was withdrawing money from an ATM at an ICBC bank in Heyuan, China earlier this year, when she was accosted by a man wielding a knife. Terrified, Li quickly gave him the 2,500 yuan, which is about as much as $375, that she had just withdrawn from the machine. But when the man was unsatisfied by the amount, he asked her to show him her account balance. Upon seeing that her account balance was at zero, however, the man simply laughs, smiles, and hands over the money that he had just taken from her. More than 20 African countries have joined together in an international mission to plant a massive wall of trees running across the continent. And after a little over a decade of work, it has reaped great success. The tree planting project, which has been dubbed the Great Green Wall of Africa, stretches across roughly 6,000 miles of terrain at the southern edge of the Sahara Desert, a region known as the Sahel. Continuing the wall's development is currently being backed by a host of international governments and conversation groups from around the world. And once the wall is completed, it will be the largest living structure on the planet, 3 times the size of the Great Barrier Reef. The Ruder Power Plant in Berlin launched a new system of technology that is using calcium oxide, also known as quicklime, to store heat for long periods of time. Germany already has the renewable energy capacity to power more than half of the country, but since many green energy sources are dependent on consistent weather conditions, the nation is forced to continue using fossil fuels as backup energy sources. Quicklime, on the other hand, generates large amounts of heat when it is simply exposed to water. A Singaporean entrepreneur has bought 10,000 unused ride-sharing bikes so he can donate them to poor students in Myanmar. Dozens of creatures that had been thought to be extinct were found alive in a lost city in the jungle. A modernized fisheries act became law in order to set the stage for rebuilding the abundance of fish in Canada's oceans. For the first time since its inception in 1868, rebuilding plans are now required for depleted fish populations. The act also ends the import and export of shark fins in Canada. Around the world, the catalyst of fishery recovery and the social, cultural, and economic benefits that come along with it has been a legally binding requirement to rebuild fish populations and prevent them from becoming depleted. In Canada, only 34% of fish populations are healthy, while more than 13% are critically depleted. Of 26 critically depleted stocks, only 5 have rebuilding plans. The Act's new provisions should change this, mandating that rebuilding plans be created for all fish populations in the critical zone, with the target of rebuilding them to sustainable levels. A simple yet brilliant new community program in the Philippines is simultaneously tackling two of the village's most serious issues, hunger and the debilitating amount of plastic waste on the streets. Despite how 1 kilogram of rice only costs about 70 cents, the costs can be financially burdened for the many villagers living in the Bayanan, who are below the poverty line. That's why the village leaders launched a program which offers 1 kilogram of rice in exchange of 2 kilograms of plastic waste. More than a dozen former members of the Canadian Armed Forces who have been forced to sleep on the streets will finally have proper roofs over their heads. The Homes for Heroes Village in Calgary is the nation's first housing complex built exclusively for homeless veterans. The village is made up of 15 houses, all of which have been equipped with everything from cable and internet to fully functioning kitchens and outdoor decks. The complex has also been equipped with additional on-site resources such as mental health support, counseling, career training, mentoring, case management, and even community gardens. Researchers from the UK-based Seawater Greenhouse Company have discovered a drought-proof way to farm fruits and vegetables simply by using solar power and salt water for irrigation and cooling. After 1 year of tireless advocacy work, the South Korean city of Seoul has finally been declared free of dog slaughter. Seoul's last 3 dog meat shops have agreed to end dog slaughter on site, following over a year of campaigning from Seoul's mayor, Park Won-soon, and the Seoul's metropolitan government. After being extinct in the wild, the Mexican wolf roams the US desert once again, thanks to a former wolf hunter. The European Commission presented a groundbreaking new legislative roadmap to make Europe the first continent to achieve carbon neutrality. In what is being called the European Green Deal, the drafted package of policies is set to undergo debate and approval by representatives from all 28 member states in January. If approved, the ambitious new laws could be implemented as soon as 2021. An aspiring new report says that the global suicide rate has fallen by 29% since 2000, with notable declines in several demographic groups of people. For starters, rates of alcoholic abuse and suicide amongst middle-aged Russian men have made a notable decline since peaking following the year of the Soviet Union. Great Britain, as well as many other European countries, has seen a reduction in suicides after rates peaked in 1934 during the Great Depression. Suicide rates in Japan, India, and South Korea have all receded since the 1990s, with Chinese women experiencing a stunning drop of 90%. And, well, that's pretty much it. Well, for the most part. I want to sincerely apologize for not putting out as many videos than last year, because, you know, during the last few months, back in 2018, it looked like I would finally be able to put up more content. But unfortunately, there were a lot of personal issues that I've went through this year, and this hasn't been the best year, so talking about some of the most positive things coming from, you know, 2019, that I hope this helped you just as much as it helped me. And, well, besides all that, I wish each and every one of you, the fans, members of Tina at Saturn, pretty much anyone who's watching this video, I wish you all Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and have a pleasant New Year.
Merry Christmas to all of my fellow reviewers from Team Night Saturn, and Tony here, aka the guy who mostly specializes in making reviews of opera productions, concerts, albums, musicals, ballet, anime, cartoons, and movies, and also the guy who is very much a hardcore shipper and loves to draw a lot of fan art of my most favorite animated couples of all time. I am thoroughly blessed to have been on this site for 2 years, and I have to thank the likes of Christine Suzaki, aka the Asian Critic Chick, and of course, the one and only Jack Skyblue, for being such absolutely wonderful people who have also believed in my talents and my potential as a reviewer. And of course, I can never go wrong with their content, which have been extremely entertaining, especially that of Christine as the Asian critic chick. You are definitely one of my most awesome and biggest inspirations of becoming the reviewer that I am today. I am very thankful to consider you as sort of like family to me and one of my, as I stated before, biggest inspirations of all time. Keep up the awesome work and may you have an equally wonderful holidays. And of course, to Jack Skyblue, for keeping the site up and running and for doing everything in your power to make great content and even quality content at that. And of course, for being such an awesome person to work with. I am so happy to have also been the voice of Rumpy in your installments. And I cannot be any more thankful than I am already. And I am extremely blessed to have been a member of Team Night Saturn. And I still can't believe it has been 2 years since I first joined the site in January 2017. So, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, and as we say in German, French, Spanish, and Italian, Frohe Weihnachten, Joyeux Noël, Feliz Navidad, e Buon Natale.